Deciding to buy a plasma cutter for your shop is a pretty easy decision, but what do you need to know before you pick out your plasma cutter? Well, it's more than just cutting capacity. The first thing you need to consider is what are you going to cut on a regular basis? Not only the thickness of the material, but the material itself. Aluminum requires the machine to work harder, so if you plan to cut a lot of aluminum, you may want to choose a machine with a larger cutting capacity. What power do you have in your workplace? Like most welding equipment, plasma cutters are available 110, 220, and even 460 in single or three-phase power. So knowing what power you will have available will help you pick the right machine. Plasma cutters require a compressed air source, and depending on the machine's cutting capacity, it will also require a specific CFM, or cubic feet per minute, to supply the machine. So you need to know this when choosing the machine. And remember, be honest with yourself. We all want a plasma cutter that can easily sever 2-inch thick plate, but that machine is gonna be incredibly large, it's gonna need a lot of power, and it's gonna consume a lot of compressed air. If you really only work in 3/8 to 1/2-inch plate, and maybe have to cut something a little bit thicker occasionally, well, there's more options of plasma cutters available for you. One last tip though, those small little pancake air compressors that you can pick up for right around 100 bucks, they will never deliver enough air to make a plasma cutter work effectively and efficiently. So don't buy it, it won't do the job.